Hi, I'm Anubhav Karmakar, and this is FitPage. Today we are going to try and understand if it's okay to split your long run. When it comes to long runs, the main benefits come from the accumulated time running. It improves the mental capacity that you need to keep going when you're ready to stop. It helps you learn how to pace for a longer distance. It teaches you what kind of fuel your body can handle and what it needs to avoid hitting the wall. The time spent running depletes glycogen stores, which triggers the beneficial adaptations that help you become more efficient at burning fat for fuel. This helps you to preserve glycogen for later in the race and reduces the likelihood that you'll hit the wall. It leads to breakdown and strengthening of muscles and ligaments that help you withstand that distance. With that in mind, the long run is best done in one go. However, you can split a long run occasionally in your training cycle. But if it's a key long run, I would consider moving it to another day or switching it with another weekend so that I could run it in one go. Let's understand some of the cases when a runner may opt to split the long run occasionally. A runner returning to high mileage training after an injury. A runner who often gets injured during high mileage training. A runner trying to manage extreme outdoor temperatures. When splitting up a long run, run as long as you can in one bout, preferably at least 60 to 70% of the mileage. Then run the remaining miles in the second session. Let's look at three different options of splitting up the long run. Option one, split across 12 hours, morning followed by evening. This is the best option as it allows for active recovery during your day and ensures you are still carrying some fatigue into the second run. But be careful with the food you're consuming during the day so that you're not too bloated or heavy for the second effort. Option number two, split across 12 hours, evening followed by morning. This is the next best option. It gets you a bit more rest with a night of sleep in between the runs. Option number three, split across two consecutive mornings. Not as optimal as the previous options, but much easier to manage. If you can do the first run on an empty stomach, you could still lower your glycogen stores in a shorter time so that you can get the glycogen depletion benefits of the run. Alternatively, you could have your normal pre-long run food before the first run and then keep the carbohydrate intake fairly low in between the two runs so that you do the second run in slightly glycogen depleted state. To summarize, if there is a conflict with the long run, then yes, you can split up the run, but do so with the understanding that it is less than ideal. This option should be used only when absolutely necessary. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to log on to fitpage.in for more videos, articles, and podcasts.